ولو كره المشركون. أما بعد، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز المحكم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. ويقول الله تعالى أيضا: إنما المؤمنون إخوة فأصلحوا بين أخويكم واتقوا الله لعلكم ترحمون. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, today in this Friday sermon, I'm just highlighting one point which I believe that all of us have heard many times and very frequently, and that is the issue of brotherhood in Islam. The brotherhood in Islam, to be brothers and sisters because of the Islam, that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained us. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us to remind this and many, many important issues from time to time, because reminding will help us. Allah says in the Quran, وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Remind them, because reminding them will be very beneficial to the believers. So we need to remind each other, and this kind of issue which is dependent on all our life. Our lifestyle in any situation, what we need is to be strong, to be smart, to be productive, to be contributive. But all that we can't do unless we believe our brotherhood that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained us in the Quran. The meaning of brother, actually in the Quran and in all common cultures, we know there are many, it can come into several ways, but each one has its own priority. For example, when you know that the most common one is that you call brother to each other because you are the descendants of one father and one mother. So that is biological brotherhood, brothers and sisters in blood, that is one side. And then there is a brother or brotherhood and sisterhood in the religion. There is a brotherhood and sisterhood in doing something, in behavior. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions all that in the Quran. Allah says in the Quran, when he is addressing the issue of the case of Yusuf, Nabiullah Yusuf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجَاءَتْ إِخْوَةُ يُوسُفُ. And he says, and the brothers of Yusuf came in. So the brothers, those are the brothers in blood. The brothers, they are the children of his father. They came. Allah used that in that sense, they are brothers. In another verse, Allah, that is in Surah Yusuf, come to Surah Al-Ahzab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Allah is talking about the case of adoption, to adopt a child and give your name to that child, Allah has forbidden. And in that forbiddance, Allah says, اُدْعُوهُمْ لِعَبَائِهِمْ وَأَقْصَدُ لَكُمْ فَإِنْ لَمْ تَعْلَمُوا أَبَاهُمْ فَإِخْوَانُكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ وَمَوَالِيكُمْ. Call them in the name of their fathers. But in case you don't know their fathers, then they are your brothers in their religion. So you can call them and you can recognize them as they are your brothers. Bring them in that situation of brotherhood because of the religion. So in this case, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that a child whose father is not known, say the girl has got this baby and she doesn't know whose father is, and nobody knows his father. So most probably, you see, we, like in our cultures mostly, we segregate that kind of person as he or she is a criminal. But the child, that baby, is innocent. Has nothing to do with their parents as them. So then, and in that situation, they are your brothers and your sisters in Islam. You recognize them in that way. There, I'm showing you that how the brotherhood in Islam is so deep, so it touches every corner. And even those who are in the same behavior, the same, same morality, same, doing everything the same way, they are called in the linguistically and even culturally and in the Quran, they are called brothers. Take an example, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us the case of Maryam alayhi salam, in Surah Maryam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying there, they said to her, when she brought the baby, Isa alayhi salam, and they have seen this baby, and they don't know his father, they automatically, they had in their mind that the baby is fatherless. And they said, they think he's illegitimate, that's what they think. So they said to her, Ya ukhta Haruna, ma kana abuki imra'a sawin, wa ma kanat ummuki baghiya, fa asharat ilayhi. So they said to her, hey, the sister of Harun, your father was not a bad man, and your mother was not a prostitute. So how come you have a baby and you don't even know his father? So then, and our point here, our target is that they used it as a brother. The brother, Harun, they made him, he's the brother of Maryam. Why? Because they were behaving the same. They had the same behavior. Same belief, same behavior, same attitude, culture, whatever. Then they are brothers in that way. And so in the, that's the definition. Just to give an abstract the definition of brotherhood. In that brotherhood, we as Muslims are always a multi-races, multi-colors, multi-languages. So we have our own differences. But we are all brothers and sisters. We all come together into one category. That is brother and sister. Because they are, all of you, we believe in the same faith. So then, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained us is to respect this brotherhood. To regard, to recognize, to regard, to respect. And then, if there is any kind of to repair it also. So what you need here is to recognize, to respect, to regard, and to reconcile. If there is to repair and to reconcile also. When there is any kind of issue that is damaging the brotherhood of the Muslims, what we need is to fix that problem. There the reconciliation comes. And Allah, the Almighty, has given us an order from the Quran, Surah Al-Hujurat. I advise everybody, myself, that we carefully read Surah Al-Hujurat and Surah Al-Nur and contemplate the meaning of those surahs. They teach us the ethics, the morality, the brotherhood, and the all kinds of social life. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us here, saying, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخْوَيْكُمْ. Indeed, believers are brothers to each other. So make a settlement between them. Then here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling this, and I need to emphasize those the wording of this ayah. Allah says, innama, the word inna ma, it gives in the Arabic translation, when it comes to the Arabic grammar, إنما is called أداة الحصر, which means it is the toolkit of restriction. When you want to say something strictly and restrictively, and also to say, to show that this is so exclusive, so exceptional, then you use إنما. That means nothing else. But Allah says then, إنما, indeed, for confirm, in fact, the reality, it is nothing but believers are brothers to each other. Believers in Islam are all brothers to each other, brothers one another. فَأَصْلِحُ بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ. Then Allah is saying, فَأَصْلِحُ, reconcile, بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ, among your brothers, between two of your brothers, between two groups, between two individuals, among groups, reconcile among them. This word فَأَصْلِحُ, Allah started saying فَ. The فَ is, means right away, immediately, go into for negotiation and mediation and settlement. So فَ is right away, immediately. فَأَصْلِحُ, reconcile among them. The word فَأَصْلِحُ, it's not sufficient to say it is to make mediation. It's not sufficient to say even to, when we are translating, it's not sufficient to be translated as also making settlement, making negotiation, all that. It is more deeper than that. It is, the meaning is to bring their hearts together. أَصْلِحُ means bring their hearts together, reunite them. بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ, among your brothers, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ, and be dutiful to Allah, fear Allah, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ, so that you may be receiving the mercy of Allah after you do that reconciliation. So through reconciliation, through bringing the hearts of the believers together, that is how you can get the verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the opposite? If you don't involve into reconciliation and bringing the Muslims together, keeping them in harmony, in unity, what comes there is the opposite. Which is that, because there you were creating life, you were planting the tree of life. But now, if you don't plant that tree of life, another tree will be planted, because there must be something going on. The other tree is the hatred tree. It's gonna grow. And that is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in the Quran. بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ. Do not argue among yourself so that you fail in your progress. You end up to failures. And when you fail, then what happens? وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ. Your power will be vanished. Your unity will all go away. And all your existence will be lasting because of lack of that, lack of brotherhood and sisterhood, and lack of love among you. And then what you placed there is hatred and conflict, which starts from argument. And when all those things happen, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us this warning, which is always you create and grow and maintain the good things. And if you don't do that, what replaces that is the bad. That's how the life is always goes on. It is very clear, and that it exactly is translatable to the prophetic tradition, where Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, he said, وَاللَّهِ لَا تُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى تَحَابُوا, لا تدخل الجنة حتى حتى تؤمنوا ولا تؤمنوا حتى تحابوا. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you will not enter the paradise, you will not enter the paradise until you become believers. But you cannot even become believers until you love each other, until you have love and affection to each other, then you cannot become believer. So then now you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمَنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. Indeed, the mu'minun, believers, are the brothers. So the two words are always and substantial to each other and complementary to each other. So if you do, if you are a believer, then you must love all the believers and make them your brothers and sisters. But if you don't do that, then your faith is not complete. It's very clear. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is what he is saying, that you cannot enter the paradise until you become a believer. And you can't become a believer until you love your brothers and sisters in Islam. Then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam continuously says, أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ شَيْءٌ إِذَا فَعَلْتُمْ تَحَابُوا. Should I not show you one thing that if you do, you would love each other? The companion said to him, yes, of course. He said to them, افشوا السلام. Spread greeting each other. So when you always greet each other, hug each other, smile to each other, then that is when you create the love. But if you don't create that love, what happens? Satan is going to create hatred then. So that's how it is. I would like to mention and appreciate their ulama, previous ulama in many parts of the world. They taught the jama'as that when the prayer is done, the prayer, all the parts of the prayer, every segment of the prayer is about unity, brotherhood. You started from anywhere, from the beginning. When you see the one who was feeling, thinking that he's so proud, so high, and he's just standing beside the one that he used to be humiliated and undermined, and he considered that this person is a subhuman being, but they are touching each other, shoulder to shoulder, feet to feet. That is the unity. They are united. So then some ulama said, okay, when you complete the prayer, after you say assalamu alaikum, everybody should handshake the person with the two persons, one the left and the other one right. People who are sitting beside you, handshake them. That one, it is not hadith, it is not in the Quran, it is just advice said by ulama. But it is helpful because it is reflective to this, to the ayah of the Quran and this hadith, that ifshu salam, to spread the greeting to each other. That is how it is. I know some, maybe some of the young generations after that will say, oh, this is bid'ah because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't know that and it was not in his time. But this one is just, it is an action which is responding to the verses of the Quran and this hadith. So I recommend that. Not only that we handshake each other as just making physical action, but from heart to heart. So the two hearts should feel each other. That is how the brotherhood can be built. And we need to build that and strengthen it and make it progressive and alive all throughout our lives, so that we can become a united nation, a united human being, a united community, and all of us are one. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم واستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, if we need to be human beings who are really doing something good in this world and preparing themselves for the hereafter, we have to protect and preserve and maintain the brotherhood in Islam. That is when talking in the category of brotherhood in Islam. And that brotherhood must be based on love. One of my previous khutbahs was how to give unconditional love to everyone, every human being. And this now, I'm saying you have to give unconditional love to your brother in Islam. Because once you make a love, love is the thing that creates you all the time. The love attracts the good things and puts you in high level. So when it attracts the good things, it elevates yourself from lower level, lower dimension to higher dimension. It makes you high with dignity, with like highness and gratitude, and gives you your values. It shows, it teaches you your own values and the values of the human being. So you understand your values, and when you understand your values, then that's how you build the love. And then that love is given to your brother and sister. And the opposite is that if you don't do that, then what comes, as I've said before, is the haters. What the haters do, scientifically, hate is the things that drag you to down, to lower level. That one of hatred and agony, enmity, and all those things, they will drag you to a lower dimension. That lower dimension is just like the gravitation of the Earth. So it's land gravity, which is taking you to down level, just like the gravity propulsion system. That's how it puts you to lower level. And that lower level, when you go to down, then you undermine it, and you degrade it, you disgrace it, your humanity. Because you put yourself into a subhuman being. And how that started? When you undermine your brother, and you do not give him his full right as a human being, immediately you create hatred. And that hatred will drag you to a lower dimension. And then you put yourself to undermine level, to a subhuman level. You are trying to underestimate and put somebody in subhumanity, but you put that into yourself. And so the love is the anti-gravity of the lower dimension. That is what we should be believing in. And when we believe in that, how we do that? We have to always correct our soul. That is when one piece of flesh in our earth, that piece of flesh is the one that can change you. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has mentioned this piece of flesh when he said, أَلَا إِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ مُضْغَةٌ إِذَا صَلَحَتْ صَلَحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ أَلَا وَهِيَ الْقَلْبُ. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us this, saying, hello, oh people, there is a piece of flesh in the body. If it goes good, every part of your body and all your body will go to goodness. But if it is corrupted and spoiled, the whole body will be corrupted. And he said, Allah wa hiya al-qalb. And that is nothing else but the heart. That piece of flesh, which is called the heart, that's the one we need to always to rectify it, to beautify it, to clean it, and to put it into the best situation. And that's the human body, which encompasses, it encompasses all God's creation. That means if the good things can come from it, and the bad things can come from it. So you need always to make clean, like a window, your heart. Make sure your heart is in the best situation, or that you do not have hatred against somebody, you don't entertain hatred and animosity against anybody. You are clean. Because when all those things happen, is that how that can be started? Whatever you love for yourself, love it for your brother also. Because nothing is empty. There's nothing so real. Everything is so abundant. So don't think when you love even for yourself to inherit the eternal life, paradise, don't think, believe that, don't love somebody that you dislike to go to hellfire. Love that person also to be with you in the paradise. Because Allah's bonds and provisions are too many. They are not something, it's not something which is lasting. So everything is available. If there's a limited resource, and that limited resource, you love to take it, you have to love it, your brother also to take it. And Allah can make that resource abundant and very beautiful, available to everybody. So it is not something that you do not restrict anything to yourself. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. No one is a believer until he loves for his brother what he loves for himself. It is that, it's very clear. And the opposite is that the things that has, you become envy. You create emptiness, and that emptiness is what the religion always tells us to avoid, to stay away from. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لا تحاسدوا ولا تناجشوا ولا تباغضوا ولا يبيع أحدكم على بيع بعضكم بعض وكونوا عباد الله إخوانا. المؤمن أخو المؤمن لا يظلمه ولا يخذله ولا يحقره. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم المؤمن كالمؤمن للبنيان يشد بعضه بعضا. رسول محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم says لا تحاسدوا, do not envy each other, and do not argue, do not backbite each other, do not argue, and do not hate each other, do not be angry to each other, and do not create anger. And one of you should not beat the price of somebody else. Somebody was buying a car for $2,000, and you say, no, I'm gonna pay because of this guy, I don't want him to buy it, I will pay $3,000. That is haram. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَكُونُوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِخْوَانًا, and be brothers in the faith of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الْمُؤْمِنُ أَخُ الْمُؤْمِنُ, the brother is a brother of the believer, لَا يَظْلِمُهُ, so he should not oppress him, and should وَلَا يَخْذُرُهُ وَلَا يَحْتُرُهُ, and should not degrade him, should not undermine him, and should not humiliate him. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam continuously says, the believer is like the other believer is like the building that is one strengthens the other. He put in his hands like this, his fingers, and he said they are all helping each other like that and becoming united. And then when they do that, that is when the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down. So the mercy comes in that way. That reflects to the ayah, which I have started, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ, reconcile among yourself, among your brothers, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ عَلَىٰكُمْ تَرْحَمُونَ, and fear Allah, so that the mercy of Allah will come to you. عباد الله يوصيكم بالتقوى الله عز وجل وأحذركم بنفسي ونفسكم بمخالفة الله ونسيانه. وذكركم بأمر بدء الله بنفسه ثم أمر بالملائكة ثم أمرنا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما وأقم الصلاة